Hata
moto umewaka,
kweli ushindi twauona.
Moto umewaka,
kweli
moto umewaka leo. Moto ni kazi ya Yesu. Moto umewaka leo. Tuimbe haleluya, moto umewaka.
Baba, nakushukuru kwa ajili ya alasiri ya leo. Asante kwa ajili ya rehema zako na pendo lako, Mungu wa Israeli. Tunakutukuza kwa ajili ya neno ambalo umetuandalia, Mungu wa Israeli. Tunapojikabidhi mkono wako Bwana, tunaungama dhambi ambayo inaweza kuwa imefichika, ambayo inaweza kuwa kizuizi. Baba, tunaing'oa katika jina la Yesu. Tunaomba damu ya Yesu itutakase na kuturehemu na kutukomboa kutokana na udhalimu mwote. Baba, utufanye kuwa safi mbele zako. Nuru yako ikaangaze katika kila sehemu ya maisha yetu. Ondoa uchafu uliofichika moyoni, Mungu wa Israeli. Damu ya Yesu itakase na kutufanya safi Bwana. Utuondolee mavazi ya aibu, utuvishe mavazi ya utukufu. Baba mfano, utunyeshee mvua takatifu Bwana katika maisha yetu. Baba mfano wa amani, uondoe shina la uchungu katika mioyo yetu. Njoo ututembelee Bwana, utusaidie katika safari ya kwenda mbinguni. Peke yetu hatuwezi Baba, tunakutegemea Bwana ili tuweze kusimama imara katika neno lako. Naomba utushike mkono, Mungu wa Israeli. Tushike mkono Baba, tusaidie kuishi maisha yaliyotakata mbele zako Bwana. Utupe neema ya kuabudu na kukutii nyakati zote Bwana, kwa kuwa ni Mungu unayetupenda. Asante kwa kuwa Baba yetu Bwana, umetupa uwezo wa kufanyika wana. Maana neno lako linasema watu waliokupokea uliopo uwezo wa kufanyika wana. Nami naomba Bwana, upako wa kuwa mwana usituache siku yoyote ile, bali uandamane nasi popote tuendapo. Utuzingire Bwana. Mfalme, malaika wako ulinzi wakituzingira pande zote. Ukuta wako wa moto ukituzingira pande zote. Nguzo yako ya moto ikitutangulia usiku, na nguzo yako ya wingu wakati wa mchana. Baba, utufungue macho. Tunakataa kuishi kama vipofu. Tunakataa kutembea kama vizui, Mungu wa Israeli. Maana sisi ni wana wa nuru. Baba, ukaangaze katika njia yetu. Tuone tunapokwenda. Tuone utukufu wako unapomulika. Baba, tusikie sauti yako inaponena. Upako wako Bwana uzidi kukolea katika maisha yetu, ukavunje nira za adui katika maisha yetu. Baba, tunaomba restoration, urejesho wa nyota zetu. Nyota zetu zikang'ae, nyota zetu zikang'ae Bwana. Tunapokuja kanisani mwetu, pasiwe mahali pa kutoka ili tuwe fukara zaidi, bali pakuwe mahali pa kuinuka na kuongezeka katika roho na hata katika mwili. Tunapokutanyika Bwana mbele ya uwepo wako, tuwe tunakutanyika mahali ambapo Bwana nuru yako itang'aa, utukufu wako utaonekana, rehema zako zadhihirika maishani mwetu, na Baba, maisha yetu yakaweza kuzaa matunda ya yasaliyo toba, matunda ya Roho Mtakatifu, tunda la Roho likadhihirike katika kila sehemu ya maisha yetu. Baba, hatuwezi bila wewe. Baba, tunakiri ya kwamba tunakutegemea ili tuishi maisha yaliyo matakatifu. Nasi tunaomba Bwana, chukua usukani, keti kwenye kiti cha enzi cha maisha yetu, utawale. Keti kwenye kiti cha enzi cha maisha yetu Bwana, utawale hata huduma hizi ambazo umetuita ndani. Onekana katika mission hii. Utakase uongozi wa huduma hii Bwana. Baba, tunakushukuru kwa ajili ya ndugu Tom. Baba, naomba usidi kumfanya kuwa baraka. Asante kwa umbali ambao umemleta. Baba mfano wa amani, licha ya matatizo mengi ambayo amepitia na dhihaka nyingi, Baba unazidi kujitukuza katika maisha yake. Nami naomba Bwana, mwaka huu usifunge kama Baba tujasikia ushuhuda wa kipekee, ushuhuda wa ajabu. Maana Bwana, mawe ambayo amesimama mbele yake Bwana, miamba ambayo imekuwa kizuizi, inaenda kupasuka, inapasuka, Mungu wa Israeli. Baba, unaenda kumpatia jina la kipekee kwa ajili ya utukufu wa jina lako. Katika ukoo aliozaliwa, Baba, unaenda kutukuzwa katika maisha yake, katika jamii yake. Baba, tunaomba right connections, divine connections Bwana. Uneno ulishusha neno kupitia mtumishi wako ya kwamba Baba unaenda kumtumia ndugu Tom. Na unaenda kumkutanisha na mtu ambaye atamuinua na atamfanya kuwa baraka katika huduma hii. Baba, mwaka huu usipite. Mwaka huu usipite. Ondoa vizuizi, ondoa pingamizi Bwana. Ingilia kati, Mungu wa Israeli. Tunadai unabii huu utimie. Baba, mwaka huu umetoa unabii mwingi. 2017 ulituahidi mengi. Baba,
Baba, mwaka huu umefika mwezi wa tisa, mwezi ambao mfano amani ni wa mazao, mwezi ambao na kuona matunda. Onekana Bwana, onekana Bwana. Tunamtaja Tom, lakini tunakumbuka wapendwa wenzetu ambao wamesikia habari kutoka kwako. Baba, thibitisha kusudi lako, thibitisha kusudi lako Bwana. Ondoa laana, ondoa vizuizi. Neno lako linasema tukiziungama dhambi zetu, wewe ni mwaminifu na wa haki, hata utuondolee na udhalimu wote. Baba, iwapo kuna udhalimu ungali unasalia, Baba, tunatubu, 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 tunatubu. Mungu wa Israeli, ingililia kati Bwana, ingililia kati. Ninadai baraka yangu, tunadai baraka zetu katika mwaka huu. Ni mwaka wa upenyo, ni mwaka wa upenyo Bwana. Hebu twende mbele za Bwana, hebu tuzungumze na Mungu kuhusu mwaka huu, kile tunataka Mungu atutendee kabla mwaka haujaisha. Baba, tuache mbele zako, tunaomba kila unabii ambao umetoa, unabii wa kuinuliwa, unabii wa kupanuka Bwana, hata katika huduma. Baba, naomba upe unabii huu uthibitike, unabii huu uthibitike Mungu wa Israeli. Baba, hawezi mwanadamu hata ukanena uongo. Baba, onekana. Tunaomba upako wa kupokea majibu ukashuke, upako wa kupokea majibu yetu ukashuke. Dada huyu ukasikie kilio cha moyo wake, ndugu huyu usikie kilio cha moyo wake. Baba, ubariki kazi ya mikono yetu, utufungulie milango, ututenge mfano wa amani na connections ambazo ni za kishetani, ambazo za kufuta chini na kututupia laana na kutuangusha. Baba, tunafunja connections hizo, fana demonic magnets of God in our lives that attracts every type of evil in our lives today. I break those that magnets. I destroy it by fire. I shatter it by fire. And I flash it out of my life in Jesus' name. Every demonic magnet in the ministry, today I shatter it. I use the word of God, which is the hammer that breaks rocks into pieces. And I break every demonic magnet in this ministry that attracts evil, that attracts failure, that attracts, oh God, further oppression in the ministry. I break it, I shatter it by the power and the blood of Jesus. And I go for the wind of the Holy Spirit to blow it away in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray, anoint us, oh God. Anoint us, oh God, with the anointing that breaks the yoke of Jehovah. Open our inner eyes, open our inner ears, oh God. Father, we refuse to walk as blind people, Jehovah. We are your children. Let your light shine in our hearts, souls, and spirits. Open our ears, open our eyes, oh God. Remove darkness in every part of our hearts, oh God. In our families, oh God. In our children, Jehovah. We dedicate them. We dedicate them to you. I pray, intervene. Intervene in our lives, oh God. Bless us, oh Father. Bring healing. Bring healing in our lives, oh God. Father, oh God. I pray that you deliver us, oh God. That you bless us, oh God. And use us as tools, oh Jehovah, to bring many into the kingdom and not to take them, oh Father, to drive them out, oh Father. Father, we pray that your hand will be upon us, oh God, to lift us, oh God. Father, enable us, oh God, to stand on top of the mountains, oh God. Set our feet on high and give us the grace to soar high like eagles in the mighty name of Jesus. Give us the grace to wait upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Baba, naomba utupe neema ya kusimama imara. Baba mfalme, vikwa ambavyo umetia ndani mwetu, utupe neema ya kujua jinsi ya kuvitunza. Baba, tusije tukaanguka kwenye maji na kupotelea kule. Baba Mungu wa Israeli, misha ya maji ya uzima ikatirike ndani mwetu, maana wewe ni Mungu mkuu. Asante kwa uwezo wako na ukuu wako. Asante kwa nguvu yako Bwana. Shuko tutakaso tunemu tukomboe Bwana, tuifadhi, utuzingire pande zote Bwana. Tufunika kwa damu yako Kristo, kwa sababu unatupenda. Tunapoenda kulisikia neno Bwana, tunaomba onekana, onekana alasiri ya leo. Onekana Mungu wa Israeli. Ondoa magonjwa, neno lako ambalo ni upanga ukatao kuili, ukakate chochote kisichofaa ndani mwetu na kutuondolea. Ukavunje nira za ibilisi, Mungu wa Israeli. Neno lako Bwana ambalo ni maji ya uzima, likatujae, likolee katika kila mmoja wetu Bwana. Neno lako likazungumuze katika kila sehemu. sehemu ya maisha yetu kwa sababu Baba unatutenda. Asante Bwana. Huduma hii ni yako. Ni kazi ya mikono yako Bwana. Unaweza kuipanua. Unaweza kuiongeza. Hatujitegemei ili huduma hii isimame. Hatujitegemei ili huduma hii iongezeke. Ila tunakutegemea wewe Bwana. Walete wandugu na wapendwa Bwana ambao umewatia alama yako katika huduma hii. Tuletee wana wa Mungu, Mungu wa Israeli. Ibilisi asije akapata nafasi na kupanga mfalme ngome zake kwa njia ya kutawanya Mungu wa Israeli. Utuondolee mkeni anayetawanya kundi, maana Baba unatupenda. Baba mfalme wa amani, malaika wa uridhisho wakadhihirike katika huduma hii. Tuingie hapo tuondokapo Bwana, uwepo hapo uwe pamoja nasi. Asante Mungu wa Israeli. Yale sikiaomba raje kwamba tuombee kwa Baba katika jina la Yesu.
Mungu yu mwema, Mungu yu mwema. Mungu yu mwema, Mungu yu mwema.
Mungu yu mwema, Mungu yu mwema. Away from it, but they know very well.
I know John has 10 and more. He's just juggling in his mind which one to bring. It's good. Keep it up. You can see from afar it's there. Amen. Yes, I want to bring as a testimony. I have a testimony. And I bet everybody has a memory verse. That is the assignment. That assignment must be done. You know, hata mtoto wako ukiwa naye pale nyumbani, kumwambia wash your socks kutoka shule. Wash your socks, eh? Kirudi jioni lazima uangalie kama socks imeanikwa. Kama haijaanikwa, utamtandika. Amen. Yes, I thank God because of the testimony that I have. You know, the testimony that you have is that something is happening already in us. And you know, a testimony that is not said, you will evaporate kama upepo, and it will never be there again. So every testimony comes to edify. So this is the testimony. I had a dream, and in that dream, I saw some people coming to me. Some people who called me bad names, who hated Nora, they came. I wondered why. Then I was still taken back to a prophecy that my brother Tony said at this pulpit. He did say that those people who were once members of this church will come back. They start coming, but then they sing back. So today at 5 a.m., one of them called me. And I told her, come to church. But she told me, you know, whatever I'm passing through is very difficult to come. I told him, unless you come, then there's no way help can come because I can't act on your behalf. Everybody must supplicate to God. The Bible says somewhere in Philippians chapter 4, verse 6, that you make your anxieties be known to God. Everything about you must be known to God. So it is you to make it. So I thank God that somebody called me, somebody you know very well, somebody who was here and ran away very, very fast. She called me even at 1:30. I told her we were still in church. So I can see the urge from deep within. Just see her coming. And to God be the glory. Amen?
Amen.
Yes, so let us not undermine any prophecy that we hear. And when they come, let us confirm them so that we know that God is a minister. Praise the name of the Lord. So if at all in the spiritual they have come, then physically they are here. We just don't see them. So, tunangojea wale ambao watakuwa kwa macho ni washangilie. Mimi nashangilia maana tayari wapiga simu kwamba wanakuja. Wanakuja. Wanakuja.
Amen.
So I thank God. Amen. Yes. Memory verse. I start with this. Beba tu mtoto ukuje naye. You know, there are sometimes when we are in church, na mtu anakaa chini. Hata naona ako na mtoto lakini anakuja tu.
Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God again.
Amen.
My memory verse comes from the book of Psalms, chapter 37, verse 4, which says, delight yourselves in the Lord also, and you shall give
you
the desires of your heart. Be blessed.
Amen. Ay, mabuki mazuri jamani. Amen. Ha. Namalize na Jeremiah iko. Let. Uwe ni basi.
Proverbs chapter 25 verse 29. It says, the fear of man
brings a snare, but who trusts in the Lord shall be saved.
Amen. Amen. If Jeremiah can, how many times you, oh my God, I feel good. I agree. You feel good.
Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God again.
Amen.
First I'd like to say, I also had a confirmation about someone who was also in this church, but all of a sudden, so in my dream, I saw her coming. I saw her actually coming, and I saw her in church as well. So I give God all the glory because I know she's here with us. Amen.
Amen.
My memory verse, I always dwell on it every now and then. It keeps reminding me that though my situation is in this place at that time, but I know God is going to show me the greater and better place for me to be. Amen?
Amen.
Job chapter 8 and verse 7. Though my beginning may be small, but my latter end shall be of great. Amen. I thank God for that.
Amen. Yani I'm going to pull out some for the week. What a
praise God. Praise God.
Amen.
My memory verse comes from the book of Luke, chapter 15, verse 31, which says, Father says, my son, you are always with me, and all that I have is yours. Amen. John chapter 11, verse 35, Jesus wept.
Amen. Unajua itafika siku nyingine utakuwa unasoma Biblia, ndakuwa tu nasema tu hiyo verse alafu unasema mahali hivyo. So juggle your mind properly. Juggle your mind properly. One time I'll just be saying that verse and then you tell me which book. Amen?
Amen.
Rhoda. Let your memory verse. Hakuna. Imepotea. Aya. Aya. Rose. Ujama majuna kwa na miambili. Sasa. Bado na mruka ruka. Kuja. Kuja Rose. Eh? Majuna kwa na kumi. Jini ya mbili.
Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
This is a challenge. My memory was got from the book of Jeremiah, 3 verse 3. It says, call unto me in the darkness. And I show you great things that you do not know.
I thought you would say 7. I thought you would just say 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm telling you. Tony's time is coming, but Mama John fast, huh? What? No, not a fast, not a come. 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 Yeye anapatianga watoto. Zile ndio anapatia watoto wa konasa.
Praise God.
Amen.
My memory verse comes from the book of Romans chapter 8 verse 1. It says, there is therefore no condemnation to those who are in Christ, to those who walk in Christ. For they do not walk in flesh, but they walk in spirit.
Amen.
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 John. Come and challenge these guys. Hey, John is coming confidently, you see. Praise God. Amen.
Praise God again.
Amen.
You know, those times you're from the shule and then you are absent from school, the teacher expects everyone to have done the assignment, regardless of where you are. So you come and then you just write things kwa kitabu and then mwalimu anaona umefanya homework. Yeah. So memory verse yangu, Genesis chapter 1 verse 1. In the beginning God created the heaven and the earth. And the earth was without form
and void.
And the Spirit of God moved over the face of the water.
Verse 3.
And God said, let there be light. And there was light.
So, yeah, and God said, let there be John. And then John appeared. So, Mama John? Mama John? Hata kama ni shirini. You know, there is power in this thing we do. Before Mama John speaks, just come. There is a certain boy, Emmanuel TV, a certain very small boy, his name is Lemuel.
Lemuel.
My name is Lemuel. And then, this boy recites Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 22, offhand. And then when he recites it before a very big church with almost 30,000 people. I'm telling you, with confidence. And when he's talking so freely and relaxed. Yeah? And he is reciting everything. Just imagine. Then TV Joshua says, this, although people are laughing, it's not funny. It is great. So it means if the evil one were to come, and you have verses in you, then there's no penetration. Why? Because Nicolaitan. In Matthew chapter 4, when Satan was coming to tempt Jesus, so Satan was there and asema imeandikwa. Satan, ikiwa ibilisi niajua andiko. Sasa je wewe ndakano ujue kiasi gani? Maana ibilisi alikuwa anasema anakuota andiko na Yesu pia ana counter attack na andiko. Anasema ingine, Yesu na counter attack na ingine. So, how much more we? Welcome.
Kutoka, Kutoka, Mungu akanena maneno haya akasema, mimi ni Bwana Mungu wako niliyokutoa katika nchi ya Misri, katika nyumba ya utumwa. Usiwe na miungu mingine ila mimi. Usijifanyie sanamu ya kuchonga wala mfano wa kitu chochote kilicho juu mbinguni wala chini duniani wala majini chini ya dunia. Usivisujudie wala kuvitumikia, kwa kuwa mimi Bwana Mungu wako ni Mungu mwenye wivu, nawapatiliza wana maovu ya baba zao hadi kizazi cha tatu na cha nne cha wachukiao, nami nawarehemu maelfu elfu wanipendao na kuzishika amri zake. Usitaje bure jina la Bwana Mungu wako, kwa kuwa Bwana hata mhesabua kuwa na hatia mtu atajaye jina lake bure. Ikumbuke siku ya sabato itakasa, siku sita fanya kazi, lakini siku ya saba ni sabato ya Bwana Mungu wako. Siku hiyo usifanye kazi yoyote, wewe wala mwana wako wala binti yako wala mjakazi wako wala mgeni wala punda wako wala mgeni aliye ndani ya malango yako, kwa maana kwa siku sita wala chochote kilicho
maana kwa siku sita Tani yako nilikwambia 20.
Sasa kama umeshikosea, umekonfuse, acha niende kwa ya tano. Kuheshimu baba na mama yako, upate kuwa na heri katika nchi ya kupayo Bwana Mungu wako. Ya sita, usiue. Usiibe. Usizini. Usimshuhudie jirani yako uongo. Usitamani mke wa jirani yako. Usitamani nyumba ya jirani yako. Wala punda wake. Wala chochote alicho nacho jirani yako. Si nimesema hizo? John chapter 40, verse 1. Msifadhaike mioyoni mwenu. Mnamwamini Mungu. Niamini jina mingi. Nyumbani mwa baba yangu mna makao mengi. Kama sivyo ningeliwaambia. Naenda kuandalia makao. Na nikisha kuandalia makao, tarudi tena. Ili niwachukue, niwakaribishe mahali nilipo, ili nanyi muwepo. Tomaso akamwambia, baba, utuonyeshe njia. Yesu akamwambia, mimi ndimi njia, kweli na uzima. Mtu haji kwa baba yangu, ila kwa njia yangu mimi. Filipo akamwambia, utuonyeshe baba, ya tutosha. Yesu akamwambia, utuonyeshe baba.
Yesu akamwambia, mimi nimekuwa pamoja naye. Sadiki ya kwamba. Amen. I want to show you something. Hizo si common. Allow me to say. Kama ni common, ambia tu mtu mwingine akuje hapa na sasa. Imagine, Mama John has done it in a very wonderful way. Mama, Amelita, Exodus chapter 20, verse 1 to verse 17. Just imagine, in chapter 20, Amelita yote. Ah, why don't you say here? I want to know if you want to say here, you want to say here, you want to say here. Sasa, sikia. Alafu baadaye, akaenda John chapter 14. I can read from verse 1 to verse 8. You can imagine. So, there's something I want to teach you because of this. You know, we may do it jokingly like this, but it is good also to do it very freely. Whenever you are going before the Lord, when you are before the Lord, I remember there was someone buying the printer on this pulpit, William Vion. The only way to pray if you were answered is in three ways. Kama niliona kwa just prayers, ama nilisikia hapa kwa pulpit. And we were told, you pray in the name of the Father. Then you can recite Jehovah, what, Jehovah, 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 Nisi, Jehovah, Jireh. And when you quote and paraphrase them, even if you know where that word exists, can be better, it helps you to pray. Then you get to prayer through the Son. Then through the Son, akapia kariri vile nitakana tuombe. So, hiyo, unaomba na maandiko. Biblia inasema, na unaparaphrase hiyo andiko. Biblia inasema, na unaparaphrase hiyo andiko. You pray through the Son. Then akasema, ombi la tatu, una pray through the Holy Spirit. Hapo sasa unaweza kuingia into the ethereal, into the spiritual, katika ndimi. Bwana sana. These are stairs in prayers. Yes. Then unafika pale sasa Bwana ametokea. Allow me to say, kama huna andiko utaombaje? Maybe mahali huko ile sphere huko, maybe like Somali, wataki kuona Biblia, hakuna kwa duka zao. Saudi Arabia mbibu hakuna Biblia huko. Maybe you could have Biblia to go up, maybe see my Jaikani again in Mahal. What will you do? And you know, it is in the power of that word that you can be sustained. So let us learn to have. In fact, meditating with the Bible is a kutuma ujue maandiko mengi sana. Even some songs that some people have sung, they have sung na maandiko. Ni nani huyo? Atokai Edom. When I heard that song for the first time, I thought si andiko. Maana alikaa akasema kutoka Bosra, sasa nikasema Bosra ni nini? Nikaona Isaiah chapter 65.
ama chapter 63 hapo mwanzo 1 2 3 inaongea kuhusu ni nani huyo atokaye Edom alafu hivyo kutoka Bosra. Kasema hey, umeandiko. So you see, the more even you know other songs and then they are inscribed with these words, inatujenga, inatujenga sana. Allow me to say, we are, most of us here are praise and worship. When I praise and worship, when you read the people in intercessory, and then on our part here, eh, do it this way, go this way. Sa singine unasema, unaweza quote kaniko seme, and the Bible says in Isaiah chapter 59 and verse 19, yes, even if the enemy shall come, yes, like a mighty flood, the Lord will raise up a high standard to help you overcome. See, unasikia, when you quote this, hiyo andiko inakuja na inakusaidia ku back. Then as people hear it, people will also be praying on the other side. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. So I want to tell us this. It is not that just we recite these things. Alafu tujigambe. No. Me, I want to tell you, I have a small ushuhuda regarding andiko. Andiko, wakati nilipo okoka, very, in early 1995, I know very well that I had a certain book. That book was known as The Desire of Ages by Ellen G. White. And in this book, ilikuwa imeongea kuhusu the Gospels, the four Gospels. Juzi ilikuwa zimeandikwa stories za Jesus, The Desire of Ages, na imekariri hizo verses ikaweka hapo juu zote. Kwa hii chapter ikiongea, all references zile zina relate, kwa hii chapter inaweka. Ya Transfiguration, kama kuna reference natoka kwa hii Gospel ingine, kwa hii Gospel ingine, wameka yote hapo juu. Then I read it like a story. Then I had another urge that now that you have read it, now read the Bible without that book. Then I started reading the New Testament booklet here locally. So I read the Gospels too, come a story, but ilikuwa inafika wakati mwingine ilifika wakati mwingine. Nasikia hii imekuwa profound. This one is just bigger. Then nina dwell half for longer. Then one day I fell asleep. Just hapo mahali pa kazi nilikuwa tu kwa katrans hivi. Na nikaota kwamba nimeona Galatians chapter 6 verse 7. Na nikaisoma hapo kwa hiyo ndoto. Then when I woke up, I remembered very well the words that I saw. So when I checked the Bible, I saw it was the very thing. Then now it became a routine. Every time that I went to sleep, I told God, give me the Bible with all its content. So the Lord started giving me. Nilikuwa nikiota, ninaota maandiko. Nilikuwa nikiota, nikiota maandiko. And I'm just at the place of work. So one day somebody came to me. And he told me, kwani wewe unakwanga pastor, kila mtu unaanga tu kuna Biblia kwa mkono. Nikamwambia, kwani mtu akiokoka tu mnamuita pastor? Akasema wewe ni pastor, kubali tu. Basi nikamwambia nimekubali mimi ni pastor. So akaniambia, wewe hata una maandiko yale unajua? He was just joking like ananikejeli kama alipush down. Nikamwambia, hey, kuna maandiko. Akasema nipe hiyo Biblia aanze kukariri. Just like that, we're just playing. And I just gave, I spat one after the other. Zile nilikuwa nazo kwa dream. Nikamwambia mali fulani nasema hivi, mali fulani nasema hivi. Then he said, ay, na yewe, vile hata hizo andiko nanisomea. Tena zinani bless, maana zinaka kama ile shida niko ndani. That is the way now he was putting it. So I said, oh, so God can speak to somebody indirectly in another way, in his own way. Then with that, I had an art, not other than reading The Desire of Ages only, but I read the Bible in its content. I read it. And sometimes I would even pray and sing, and my tears would roll down. I didn't know that that is how the Holy Spirit comes. Me, I didn't know. There was nobody next to me to teach me. So in those days, in that younghood, in that childhood, stage of salvation, I remember that I used to sing a lot, and I used to pray, and I also used to cry before the Lord, just releasing myself, and anything that came I would do. Then those are the times when, again, a time came when I used to dream now. I dream that I'm rambling in tongues. Then during the day when I'm sitting at the gate, in that gate that I was, at that gate where I was sitting, it was an enclosed gate that nobody could enter. Only wild animals could enter. Why? It was a company that was closed. And the fence all around was bushy. There were wild animals which could crawl into the company, like snakes. So you could imagine that I was supposed to be awake 24/7. Because maybe a rat has just gone by. Maybe a mongoose has passed there. Maybe a snake is there. But I could speak about these spiny caterpillars, they were all over. So sleeping to me was just a nightmare. So instead of sleeping, sometimes I would sing and I would just say, oh my God, why am I trying to tell you this? I'm trying to show you that there is power in the word that you have, the word that is in you. That word, it brings a remembrance for you to go before God. Not just to brag about that, I know. No, it's not about what you know. But it's about a word that is embedded in you that you have practiced. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
When we were being taught by Preston, Pastor Preston and Akina, there is a day they brought something like, you should read the word, then you should observe it, then interpret it. Then they gave people assignments to go and do. You know, this is a very, it is a very theological concept. But it really applies even in nowadays life. When you read a verse, and then you become conversant with it, when you meditate upon it, it is like you are observing it. Then you meditate with it, you pray with it, then you apply it in your life. Then it becomes part of you. Then now you can be able to interpret it. You can never be able to interpret something until you apply it in your life. Or even if you were to interpret it, then eventually you must apply it so that it sticks to you. Praise the name of the Lord. So when I remember those, I can say that everything that we have been taught is for our own good. Everything. And I thank God that we are able to catch. More so, I will say, let us again dig deeper. In our own time, let us read the word of God. There is someone that was left half-mast by Tony. Maybe he's going to complete it here before he goes away. And then he will click complete at just prayers. He says this way. Post your Bible there. I want to see whether it is good. I don't know. I don't remember. But he was saying something behind it. He's going to complete that. So he was saying, post your Bible. Then we posted our Bibles there. You took a picture on a bigger Bible. We're going to post up. People posted theirs. We just made a ruka. Zingine ati meruka page one. Baka kava. Baka mtu anaona. Fungwe tule page ya kwanza aseme hii ni ena hivi. Unaelewa? Zingine zimeparara, zingine zimechafuka. Zingine ziko covered. Unaelewa? So, when he started giving some analysis regarding every Bible, he gave. This is what I want to say. Yes, he was saying something like, how do you know that your Bible is consecrated? If I can paraphrase what he was trying to say. So then he said that he was going to show somebody how you can consecrate that Bible so that you use it and then it brings more valor to you. Yeah, if I can paraphrase, it's going to conflict that I know. Sahi ndani yake inaboil tu. Nangojea tu yote hiyo kama ni saa ngapi. Inakuja. Bwana sio sana. I want to tell us this. The more time that you give yourself before the Lord, matters a lot. But what matters most is how much of you have given for God. Not just to show, but when you are glued to it and you can eat every word, then you will be able to apply it and even to share it so that it is of value to the others. The Bible says somewhere in 1 Timothy, in 2 Timothy 2:2, it says, and these words which you hear from me go and share it with other people so that those people can also be able to teach other people. So, how is it that the word that has blessed me, even I can also give it to you so that you not only get it, but you can also make it germinate in you and apply it to yourself so that you can also teach the other to own it. So let us own every word we hear. Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Brother Tony, welcome to complete that part. God bless you.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. I just want to conclude. Because to measure cooler, the cooler doesn't require Lisa. One has a few.
Amen.
God is good.
All the time.
Njua nimetoka hapa, nikena nika ubiri mali pengine, nikefika kwa nyumba, nikona about there is time. Nikapata mtu wapika ugali na mbuta. No, I like mbuta so much, eh? So I ate my mbuta, then I came back here. God has a few, sir.
Amen.
Yeah, so I just want to conclude. Many things have been said concerning the consecration of the Bible and finished that in your exam. Yeah. What has it been?
Amen.
So I think I gave you an assignment. Some Chronicles, eh? What are these Chronicles? And I didn't follow up. What has it been? Once again, I got hooked. And I feel like what they are. But I thank God. So, I feel like I'm played out. Do you want to message? You want to? You talk about the girl who delivered a message, but they give me. So I feel like the issue. Amen.
Amen.
But I just want to say something small concerning Joseph. Today we're just talking about Joseph. But I'm going to tell you about Joseph. So the answer to Joseph is that man is here, Joseph. Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Exodus 37. There is a reason behind hatred. People cannot hate you without a reason. And the most thing that can lead to hatred from people is not because of your bad manners, it's not because of who you are, but it is because of your God-given ability. God has it for you.
Amen.
And sometimes people may not hate you because you have a degree. Sometimes people may not hate you because you are riding on a Mercedes. Sometimes people may, in fact, when you are riding on a Mercedes, people will love you so much because they know that you will give them handouts. Sometimes people will not hate you because you are married. Sometimes people will not hate you because you have money, because you give them handouts, isn't it? But people will only or always hate you because of what God has deposited into you. Amen.
Amen.
I'm just talking about hatred. That's my thing. The Bible says, and his brothers say to him, shall you indeed reign over us, or shall you indeed have dominion over us? That's Genesis 37 verse 8. So they hated him even more for his dreams and for his words. You know, people can hate you because of your dreams. People can hate you because of your words. Some people say that they are being hated because of their appearance. They are being hated because of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 things that they have. No, that may not be the reason behind your hatred. People will only hate you because of what God has given you. Yes, that will lead to direct or automatic hatred towards you. What does it do, sir? Because things of God are unique. You know, Mercedes is not a unique thing because even the Gentile has it. But what about that dream, that gift of a dream that David, that Joseph had? Yes, it led to hatred. Why? Because he was a dreamer of dreams. The Bible says that when he dreamt the first dream, his brother hated him. No, his hatred began when his father made him a coat of many colors. His brothers hated him. The second phase of hatred is when he dreamt the first dream. Yes, his brother hated him. It reached a point that he dreamt the third dream. The Bible says that his brother hated him and envied him also. You know, what has the favorite for me? You know, the more you expose what the Lord has done for you, the more you attract hatred. And I'm telling you, the more you attract this hatred, it's the same hatred that can help you to catapult you to another level. Let me repeat what I said in the morning. In your persecution, rejoice. You don't have to pull back when people hate you. Yes, in fact, they have to hate you the most for God to elevate you the most. Am I making sense?
Yes.
You know, when you're living in a family whereby you are surrounded by crooked siblings, yes, they do all sorts of evil. They visit magicians, they get money crookedly, they conspire, do the bad and negative things to the extent they don't have a name. Yeah?
Yeah?
Yeah. They have money, but they don't have a name. The Bible says that a good name is better than silver and gold, isn't it? But you in that family, you are not that money, but you have a name. Yeah? You are the gold and silver in that family. You know, your crooked brothers will end up hating you. Why is it that this man is not behaving like us? Why is he not visiting magicians? Why is he not dancing kanungoteko with us? Huh? What are you doing? So that can lead to hatred from these people who are surrounding you. I've been experiencing these things in our family. Yes. If I look at my cousins, they abuse their parents. Some of them beat their parents. They beat them up. Most of them are cursed. So when they look at our family, they see that there are some people there who are very much disciplined. Yeah, they have money than us, but yeah, they hate us. Why? Because of our standing. Because of our discipline. Why? Because the other people who are not our relatives, yeah, the outsiders in our village, know that this family is blessed. Why? Because they are not in scandals that surrounds them with curses. What about this one? This one has curses. They are rich, but they are ending. You know what I thought to admire that you are Amen. Yes, mutu akilaaniwa in the village. They know so much. They know very well. You know, this man, even if he's dreaming about seeds, there is nothing there. Even if every sibling in that family are riding cars, has cars, yes, still there is nothing there. They know that, even people of the world, isn't it? So, if they know, especially these haters, if they know very well that in your family, yes, there is a seed of prosperity, there is a seed of divine protection, yes, they will end up hating you. Yes, to the extent that you lost yourself. Why is it that my siblings are hating me? Why is it that my parents, my sister, my brother, my cousins, yes, are hating me? It is because of what the Lord has deposited on you. David was just a nobody. He didn't have money. Yeah? In fact, he was just a second last born. Yeah? But his brothers hated him because of the dream. But the Bible says that when he endured and passed the test of hatred, what happened? He was blessed and elevated by fear of us. But that was not over. Let us see the outcome of passing the test of hatred. Genesis 49. Genesis 49:29-22. Before he died, don't forget about the governorship. That was just still a fictitious glory. Yeah? So this was a generational, blessing, yeah, that the Lord released unto Joseph's life through his father Jacob. And this is it. Genesis chapter 49, verse 22. So these are the benefits of passing the test of hatred. Do you know, before the Lord elevates you, yes, he brings a test. And the outcome of that elevation depends on how you are going to score in that test. And sometimes, before the Lord elevates you, if there is a temptation that recurs in your life, often, yes, that is a test. You have to know that it is not a curse, it is not a demon, it is a test. Not a temptation. But God never tempts us, but he tests us. That's, for example, kulikuwa na mtu alikuwa anaomba anaomba anataka kugombea kiroho. Sasa Mungu anataka kumrelease this man. Eh? Well, sasa Mungu anataka kumtoka with the some release ampatie pulpit. Majaribu inakuja mwanamke. So this man anafoid sexual sin. So that man anarepent, anarepent. Tena anaanza kutafuta Mungu next year. Tena anakuja anakuja. Sasa ndio anapitia kwa upewa na kuponyoka. Mwanamke sexual sin. So imekuwa hivyo miaka nenda miaka rudi. Bwana asifiwe. And that's what happened to Joseph's life. Yeah? Hatred. People are hating you without a reason. Isn't it? But hey, how did he used to respond to that hatred? Positively. He never fretted, never complained. You know when you fret, when you complain in your test between you and God, yeah, the Lord demotes you. Or the Lord leaves his glory that he was just about to release unto you. Bwana asifiwe. So Joseph never fretted. In the Bible, Joseph never fretted. Yeah? How could I complain? He never complained. He just took everything positively. So, we see that he outsmarted the test of hatred by being positive. He never even told his father. Isn't he? He just knew that his brother hates him so much, but he kept the matter to himself. So we see the story very well that when he went to Potiphar's house, what happened? Yes, after Potiphar's wife tempted him several days, because as we read in the morning, yes, to my view, he was tempted severally. But he outsmarted that. So that wife, Potiphar's wife, a desperate housewife, hated him and conspired against him to devour him. But he never complained. He never defended himself. Alijamaza. Was that man mad? Mwenye unaikena scandal? Na ujitetei, unasimali, just okay, we nieke kwa jela. Bwana asifiwe. Hapo hii ambia his master, huu mwanamke aliniekelea. Never. He never told anyone the story behind what happened. Hata vile alienda kwa jela, hakuambia watu what happened. Who just there. But the Bible says that the Lord was with Joseph. But he used to shine. Why? Because he never fretted. You know, complaints leads to backtiming. Fretting is the blessing of backtiming. That's the blessing of delay. And that's why Sunday mkwa na kubariki. Sunday mkwa na kuletea prophecy. I want to do this to that person. Anakadangani majaribu inarika. Ni majaribu gani urika kwa maisha yako. Sunday mkwa na kuletea breakthrough. Ana kuletea mtu wa kudharau. Isn't it? Mungu anashukatia wale huyu. Ana respond. Aje, how will you respond to that madharau? Alafu unalipuka. Penda, mi hata stand. Unawacha service, unaenda. Leo siku hakuji kuimba, unatoka, unaenda mapema, you fail the test. So after that, tena unajirecollect, recollect, you forgive that person because the Bible says forgive. Isn't it? Ati na unaanza pray. Tena unaenda kubombea, unaenda kufika somewhere. Eh? The same majaribu inakuja. Another person. Ana kudarao. Tena poof, poof. Tena una back to normal, yeah? Bwana asifiwe. And that's what happens. That's what leads to backtiming. Joseph never backtimed. Why? Wherever he went, he prospered. From the pit, to the merchants, to Potiphar's house, everything that he used to do, yes, even out of stress, he used to prosper. He used to take everything in his life, anything that negates his life, you should take it as a test. Anything that negates your spiritual growth, take it as a test. And the outcome of that test will determine if you go, if you join secondary school or you remain in primary school. That's why many believers are still in primary school, because of their response to the tests that the Lord is bringing unto them. So, after winning all those tests before the Lord, first, he was blessed materially. He became a governor. You know that, isn't it? Yes. Even after he became a governor, he never fought anyone. Do you know that? Yes. He never avenged against Potiphar's wife. That was history to him. You know, sometimes I go and I was surfing because I'm doing my dawazi. Isn't it? And if you're going to go and I was surfing, I will prosper materially. Ada kama njia ukoka. Do you know that? Yeah. So, after that, before Apathy, another breakthrough. Now, before Apathy, a spiritual breakthrough. His brother coming back to him. The people who sold him. The people who conspired against him. The people who fought his ministry. The people who fought his God-given ministry. Came back to him. This time they were poor and he was rich. They said that he looked unto them. He cried. He went unto them and told them, I'm Joseph, whom you sold. Hey! His brother cried. His brothers cried. They really cried. He had power to destroy them. He had power to remind them what they did for him. But he didn't do it. In fact, they're the one who reminded him. What did you tell them? Don't even think about it. It is gone. It's because of what you did that I'm whom I am. So you are haters. You have to respond to your haters like that. It is because of you that I'm whom I am. Hey, rejoice in the Lord, and then I say rejoice. Rejoice in your persecutions. Because without those persecutions, you will not be where you are currently. Kama singe pitia leni nipitia pa wilderness. Kudarauliwa, kutoa miniwa, kufanywa. Singe kuwa where I am currently. Is that true? Yes. Hey, that's why I nikiandika nikia post kwa Facebook ama kwa diaspora mtu alitusi. Mtu aliite mini ne, mini we, mini kiki, mini z, mini b. Yeah? Si esi jani. Why? Because I passed through a military training. Yeah? So hizo mtu anachukua kama vitu shallow, you know, I'm bigger than that. Na hizi kama hujapitia vitu kama hizi. Bwana asifiwe. Una strike wa moja na ulikuwa umesha kwa international, eh? But utaisha within 1 second. Not why post anything, unaweza kama ni group moja ikae. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
So your success depends on how you are going to deal with your haters. So after that, yeah, after he was blessed materially, there was a spiritual blessing that the Lord released unto him. Why? Because of his love. Because of responding to hatred with love. That's why the Bible says in the book of James, you cannot respond evil with evil, but by good. Genesis 49, 22. Joseph is a fruitful bough by your well. His branches run over the wall. Well, the archers have bitterly gripped him, shot at him, and hated him. You see, this is a divine blessing now. Mungu anakumbuka, huyu mtu aliwahi chukiwa, aliwahi dhulumiwa, lakini alisimama na mimi. So it doesn't matter ni anakuroga. It doesn't matter who is hating you. Eh? What matters is, how are you standing with your God? The archers have bitterly gripped him. Bitterly gripped him. Maadui walimchukia kwa uchungu. Yeah? Na walikumwambia walikuwa wanamwangalia wanalia. Isn't it? Wakamtupia mishali. Na wakamchukia. Mishali ni masengenyo. Laana. Eh? Na wakamchukia. But he sustained his anointing. By responding to that with what less kind of attitude. And forgive them. This was the blessing. This is how the blessing goes. But his bow remained in strength, and the arms of his hand, of his hands, were made strong by the hands of the mighty God of Jacob. From there is the shepherd, the stone of Israel. Wow. By the God of your father who helped you, and by the Almighty who bless you, with blessing of heaven above, blessing of the deep that lies beneath, blessings of the breast out of the womb. The blessing of your father have exhaled the blessing of my ancestors up to the utmost bound of the everlasting hills. There shall be one, there shall be on the head of Joseph, and on the crown of the head of him who was separated from his brother. Wow. So that's a blessing. Yeah? After being hated, tunaambiwa, his bow remains but his bow remained in strength, and the arms of his hands were made strong. You have to be strong for God to strengthen you. Mungu wasn't angalia your efforts. That's why the Bible said that, and the Lord left him so that he test him, to see if he can seek me without me. Yeah, the Lord knows that you can't seek God without God, but sometimes he will draw his spirit from you. Mungu anakaroa Mungu kwako ndio usewe. Awa ndio huyu mtu atariaktaje kama binadamu. Yeah? Sasa ndio kulipuka na unafikiria, "Eh, hata hivyo nimeokoka, unarudi nyuma." Eh, Mungu anakwambia this man is a man after my heart. Barcelona unalipuka. Unalipuka, unalipuka, unalipuka. Eh? Unatukanana, unalaani. Unaanguka the test. So ina kama hiyo mwaka ulikubarikiwe. Mungu ana postpone hata siku ma next year. Hey, that's why kuna watu wengine prophesy. This year you receive, you receive. Before you receive there is a test. Jiulize hiyo mwaka, ni kama jaribu gani kana kufuatana kila mwaka. Yeah? Haya, na hiyo mwaka ulireactaje? Ulireactaje last year? That is the reason behind your mark timing. So you have to be strong for God Almighty to strengthen you. Amen. Biblia inasema atapasua ukuta, atakuwa na this man atakuwa na hakuna kuleta simama mbele ya Joseph. Yeah? It's not Joseph alone, but his descendants, his children will never beg for bread. Because Joseph is a righteous man. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, jiulize ni majaribu gani ugonga unaisha. Do you pray? Do you fast? Year in, year out. Do you prophesy to you? Are we liars? No, you are the one who is fooling yourself. It's because after prophecy, there is a test. See, when a prophecy of heaven, we'll go to heaven. But before we go to heaven, there is a test. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, before we go to heaven, there is a test. Test me, fellowshipping with Jesus Christ. Isn't it? So, you reason, test me, you will be a new one. You will be a new one. Unakasirika mpaka unakuwa pissed off. Najiuliza hiyo kitu inafanyikanga kwa muda mgani? Masiku gani? Mwezi gani? Yeah, because inakuwa mwezi wako wa test. Mungu anakojanga tu ile siku utapita hiyo test. Kwisha. You receive from God. But unakuja unaomba unatubu leo. Mungu atakuja ametubu na ameomba sasa. Atatuma malaika. Enda na hiyo blessing. Atakuja kabla malaika akuje. Kuna kalesa angel. Kanatumija kanatumija, same majaribu. Ona za kuribiu, diba na shindwe, hiyo mapepo, Mungu kajaga huyo mtu. No, if you do that, you are responding negatively. Zingine angalia huu, tolea huku wa isogo, eh. Mtu bisho Mungu ndo buwa kashimo hapa, hizi ni. Za kutuwa zile vitu wameona huyo, huku mbele. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah, so that's the reason behind your pastor. Hanyi watu wanambia kwa roo. Yeah, you can go and so we will be blessed like Joseph. Watch yourself. The problem is not with your God. The problem is not a demon. But the problem is your attitude towards your challenges in life. Amen. Amen. And that's why your blessings from God are superior than those haters who are hating you. Your blessing from God are superior than that person who is trying to kill you. You are gift. You are God-given gift. Yeah, Joseph and Kwaranga, Mungu wake anaona, my God is too great. See, I'm compared to my haters, my brothers, my Potiphar's, my desperate housewife called Potiphar's wife. No, those people are too down for me. Kuna mtu amekuzwa? Yeah, that's what I was going to say,
amen. 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 Minasima, sita nyamaza, sina baba, zaidi yako. Minasima, shida yangu, wako.
Oh, minasima,
minasima.
Give me to my
Fellowship with the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forevermore.